When was the last time you masturbated and did I pop up into your head?
Oh boy.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you two and how do you know each other?
I'm Jenna.
And I'm Chris. And
we're separated.
We're separated, yeah.
Is it weird saying that?
Well, a little bit. We're still getting used to it. Still don't know what to call her to my friends, my soon-to-be ex-wife, just call her my wife. I don't know.
Yeah.
You two live together?
Yes, we do, temporarily.
We share a travel trailer.
Do you sleep in the same bed still?
Yeah.
Does that get weird?
It did get weird a couple of times, but pretty decent sized bed. We got our own corners. Okay. What part of my body do you miss the most?
I like your butt. You got a nice butt.
Do you still get to see her butt?
It pops up every once in a while.
So, I don't know, we change in front of each other. There's not, a lot of space, I guess.
Describe the best sex we've had.
I really liked the very first time that we had sex. He took me on his motorcycle and drove me out to, some abandoned dock that, in the middle of the night, it was, 2 a.m. or something like that on a lake, and it was just, a cute little memory. I think that would probably be my favorite.
Yep,
we're really pretty physical at the beginning.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. No, I can't even compare anybody else.
Always had a hard time with the eye contact, though.
Yeah, neither of us like eye contact very much.
Do you wear blindfolds during it, or?
Oh, no.
It happened. Well, I mean... Anyways, I'm just starting to imagine my boss and my coworkers watching this, and I was like, oh God, am I really talking about this right now?
All right.
Next.
Did we have breakup sex?
Yeah, a few times.
Yeah, there was certainly a few instances, but I wouldn't say it was like breakup sex.
No.
Yeah.
So when's the last time?
I'm gonna drink to that one.
I'll join you.
Was it today?
It was not today.
It was not today. No,
was
it wasn't.
It in the last week?
I think it's been longer than a week. When was the last time you masturbated and did I pop up into your head?
I mean, I'll say
I found your Vaseline.
Your Vaseline.
That's not
it
my
just
Vaseline.
Happens to be in the bathroom, all right? Within the last week or so. And I guess, you popped up in my mind. Oh boy. We've never even talked about this. That's kind of our own private thing.
I guess so.
But here we are. Why didn't it work out?
I just think that both of us kind of got tired of trying to make it work.
But what's not working?
Probably, so there's a big ideological difference politically sometimes. I would rather just focus on myself and not get involved in what I believe are things that I can't change.
He's very driven to his future, like money and career isn't a priority for me.
Well, I mean, I was worried about our future.
Yeah, but you wanted me to be participated in putting those building blocks down, and I guess I couldn't be there.
I had kind of felt it coming for a long time. You know, I loved you and cared about you a lot, which makes it really hard because, you know, we're that close to having forever love, which is sad, but yeah. Which friend or family member was glad we divorced? That is so specific, it hurts.
His dad and I don't really get along. He's visibly very happy about the decision.
I think he knows kind of the same thing that we know, that you and I don't have the same objectives.
Sure. But he also really doesn't like me, and you know that.
Yeah.
We've butt heads a lot. It's gotten to a point where we pretty much just avoid each other completely.
Yeah.
Did you ever develop feelings for someone else while we were married?
Not really anything serious.
Earlier in our relationship, before we were actually married, you almost cheated on me.
Well, I thought about cheating on you. It was on my mind, and I got pretty close to finding another girl, but I just felt horrible about it and never did anything about it, but
yeah,
that caused some turmoil.
That definitely caused lasting damage throughout our relationship for sure. Trust is really important to me, and it took you a long time to tell me about it. It wasn't the next day you were oh, this almost happened. It was months later.
Was it months later? I thought it was within a couple weeks.
No, it was. Yeah, it was months later. Yeah. And so it just, I don't know. I definitely was always really jealous in our relationship. I had it in my mind that you were just going to cheat on me at some point.
I kind of scarred the relationship pretty early.
Yeah.
Who loved who more?
Genuinely, I would say that I loved you more. You wanted to break up with me a few times, and I think you still love me, but I was definitely the one holding on, you know, fighting for it.
Yeah.
Are you in a new relationship, and what does your current partner think of me?
Nope, I've got onto dating sites and stuff like that, but nothing yet. We haven't even like stopped living together yet, so I think that'd be a little bit uncomfortable.
Hasty.
And kind of rude. Have you been talking with anybody?
Not.
I'm pretty sure I know exactly who it is, too.
A little bit, but not explicitly.
Who is this person?
Please, Jenna.
We play World of Warcraft together. It's just been some talking.
Yeah. I know enough about him that I think that you two would be good together. You know, there's still a little bit of the possessiveness and like, you know, she was my wife, my girlfriend thing. And so there have been moments where you two have like been together digitally. That made me really uncomfortable. I thought like, you can do that on your own time, not like right next to me. Like I gotta get over myself and my own emotions, but it's hard for those emotions to actually like mature and subside and go away. And
yeah.
What would it take for us to get back together?
I'm not sure if that's like an option. I'm not sure if like we would change in a way that would ever like make it so that we're compatible.
I wanted it to.
I tried changing. We tried.
Legitimately tried. And that's what I have to remind myself, because I mean there are some times where I think like it would be really nice to get back into where we were at and feeling comfortable and being together, because like it is hard to let go of all the dreams and the love and all that stuff. I admittedly have cried quite a bit about it, but it is what it is.
Another shot?
You
end it on?
On in?
Yeah.
Would you recommend this game for divorced couples?
Absolutely.
For divorced couples, yeah, it might help you get over some stuff.
If you're getting divorced, play it truthordrink.com.
Nailed it.